Hi, this is Gaurang from ZoomTV.com and I have with me two young and talented stars with us, Parineeti Chopra and Arjun Kapoor, and they're here for their film Namaste England. So first of all, welcome to ZoomTV.com.
Thank you.
So I'm sure people are talking about your chemistry and all that stuff, but I want to say it, I can say I read it somewhere, but it's there in my head. So the thing is, there was Raj Kapoor and Nargis, There is Dharmendra and Hema Malini, there is Shahrukh and Kajol, and now there will be Arjun Kapoor and Parineeti Chopra.
Oh God!
What do you have to say on that?
Indigestion.
बहुत बड़ी चीज़ है. Thank you. I think that वो तो audience decide करी. Arjun, they've given us love in Shakzade. They're liking what they're seeing in Namaste England. And that's our intent as two actors, because we get along and we see potential in creating good films together. But the names that you've taken is not in our hands. Completely on the basis of what people decide.
Yeah, I just feel, I think, if I may say so myself, there are some on-screen couples that are iconic, the way you said. So I can never even say, yeah, we are also like that. But yeah, like he said, the intention is to have a strong couple here, because I think we look good together. There is good chemistry for a great love story. We did Ishaqzade. Whatever I see of Namaste England, I feel like the chemistry cannot be questioned. So if we can achieve that, that'll be amazing. But these are couples who've done so many love stories together and have reached an iconic status. So if both of us can reach that, that'll be amazing.
Well, I'm sure looking at the trailer of Namaste England and looking at Ishaqzade, that day is not far away. Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
So, secondly, I'm loving that social media banter you guys are sharing on Instagram. My personal favorite is the one you shared 6 years and she's still mad, that meme you shared.
I have some more like that that I'd saved for marketing. Now that you reminded me, I must tell the digital team, they had made some. What I told them was, I said, Ishaqzade and Namaste England ke ओवरलैप में कुछ कुछ चीजें हैं, वेरी इट लुक्स रियली इंटरेस्टिंग कि पहले मैं बंदूक लगा रहा था, अब मैं ऐसे माफी मांग रहा हूँ. इट लुक्स द सेम, बट दैट्स द फन पार्ट ऑफ बीइंग एबल टू पुल समबडीज लेग हु अलाउज यू टू आल्सो. सो दैट्स द फन पार्ट ऑफ सोशल मीडिया बैंटर. वुडंट बी एक साइड से नहीं हो सकता, बिकॉज शी अलाउज मी टू, आई एम एबल टू डू इट. बट दैट्स आई गेस दिस इज ऑल्सो वॉट पीपल इंजॉय अबाउट अस एज अ कपल और एज अ पेयर. एज अ यूनिट टुगेदर इज दैट वी आर नॉट जस्ट ऑल अबाउट द सैपी गुई रोमांस which is on screen. Off screen there is a personality which you embrace and enjoy also as people who like us.
The thing is, I never realized it was anything unique till people saw it from an outside perspective. Both of us have always been like this. We've never spoken formally to each other, we've never complimented each other or had any kind of formalities between each other ever. We were always like this.
Those two London videos just changed people's minds about what we are.
People made us realize how special our bond was. We've organically from day one, we've been like this. I mean from the first year. So, so it's just amazing that we got an outside perspective. People telling us that no, both of you have something very different and very special. We didn't realize it. We've just always been like this. So people call it banter, but yeah, this is our normal. This is absolutely our normal.
Abnormal would be if you are formal with each other.
मैं तो नहीं कर सकती. मैं तो हमेशा, I always tell people this, that we call each other on our birthdays. And we'll never say the words happy birthday to each other. I've never heard him say, "Acha happy birthday, Pari." मतलब ये तो हो ही नहीं सकता. I can't say happy birthday. It's too formal. I'll call him. He'll know that I'm there, he'll call me. But we'll talk about everything else and keep the phone, you know. So it's just that it's a very weird connection with him that I have from day one, which people made me realize that there is.
But I think that's the charm what people are loving, because there's no like wo fake jo pretense
nahi. Yeah, that there's, is there's, never there.
It's not that.
Yeah.
So was it in a way awkward for you both when people started tweeting that these guys should get married and all that stuff?
Well, that's also a compliment.
Yeah.
Right? The equation of the relationship is so strong that people see it as something that should last forever. Mm-hmm. Okay. In the way marriage is supposed to be something that is more permanent. But like we keep saying in other interviews also, I think friendships are way more permanent than any other relationship, because you form friendships by yourself.
You choose them.
So I think a friendship as a bond is equivalent to even bigger than a formal signatory relationship like a marriage.
Yeah.
It doesn't put any pressure. Friendship creates a nurturing environment organically. So I think people want to give it permanence. What they, I guess, have a fear is that maybe they will stop working together, they will stop being like this together after this film is over. That's not the case.
Yeah.
So that permanence will always remain because of the people that we are and what we've been through together. So it's not correlated. You don't have to be married to have this kind of tuning or pairing or thought process. I think this comes more as to individuals who love each other unconditionally regardless of anything else.
So like I can understand that as fans when they're seeing that, because what we see on screen, we perceive that
these
two.
Correct, yeah.
This is true.
Yeah, this is true.
Exactly, and that's we have a lot of like whoever our fan clubs or whoever they are, right from like young people to older people, and if they all are able to see that, oh, these two can actually be together, or they are actually very good as a team.
Yeah.
That's so wonderful, because we are doing a love story ultimately, and we are friends. So. And like I said, I don't think both of us also realized how unique or whatever we were together till people made us see it that way. So it's a strange revelation of sorts, even for me.
You know, it's funny because back in like in 90s when I was like 6 or 7, so I when I got to know for the first time that Shahrukh is already married, I was heartbroken. And it's not...
yeah.
Okay, so they are not together.
They are not together.
Life.
You mean Shahrukh and Kajol,
Shahrukh and Kajol, yeah.
Yeah, I think...
But it's true, even I didn't realize that with the what do you call... I saw how people were upset when they realized Imran Khan was married.
Yeah.
Mm. You know, when he came, you watch a heartthrob and they realized, oh, he's married. Even with Hrithik Roshan,
so
but it's so cool to see it's changing, man. Now when you have Anushka has just got a publicly, she's been still loved and being recognized for what she's done. Kareena continues to be a mother and work. So I think in that sense, the love is pure from the fans, but there's also a respect and understanding of the evolution of an actor's life also.
So now they have started seeing an actor and a human like two different entities.
The social media has allowed the
personal life also to come out in front, and then they're able to make that segregation. So that's, I mean, it has its pros and cons, but this would be the pro, that people are able to look at you as an actor on a poster and also ignore what is your, whatever your status in life.
Okay.
So that's a good thing. No?
So talking about the movie, the in one line, I think the story is you follow your dream and he follows you.
No.
From what I have perceived from the trailer.
It's a little more layered than that.
Okay.
Yeah, it's much more wonderful than that, and it's something that personally really attracted me to the script, that here it's not that. It's, yes, it is a girl and a wife of a very conservative, a very simple man from a simple little place in Punjab, and yet he's so broad-minded, and he's almost like an equal and a friend to the wife in the film. And when the wife says that I have certain dreams and I want to do this in life, he says, yes, I'm going to help you do it, let's do it together as a unit. We don't have to not be married, or I mean, nothing changes. I'm your husband, and hence I'm here to live this life with you. And I really liked that in the film when I heard it. Because I thought that would become the conflict. I thought the conflict would be that the boy says, okay, now I'll have to do what you want to do, or maybe he doesn't allow her to do it. But actually the flip was no, they both want to do it together. So that was such a modern thing. That was such a thing that I would appreciate in my real life also. So that's the reason I did the film, and I love Param's character for that reason.
So initially when the film was offered to both of you, was there this discussion that what she said about that character shouldn't come as negative or grey when your character?
No, his character is only positive.
Mine can't, because the thing is, he doesn't do anything wrong. Circumstances happen. It's not that he can't, he doesn't want her to live her life. He's only helping her in fact. But that's when you see the film, you'll realize that there is no right and wrong in situations sometimes. It's just about a person. It's sometimes whether you make a choice for two people or you make a choice for yourself.
Okay.
And is it wrong to sometimes think about yourself before your partner or before your marriage? Is it, if you are not happy, how can you keep a relationship alive? If you are not happy, how can you keep anybody else happy? So these are small layers that come in. And also it is about, at some level, you also believe that your partner will understand if you take a strong decision. And that's what she says. Nobody else will understand what I'm doing, but you will understand. She makes a bold choice to go and pursue something that she feels she needs. She needs to breathe. She wants to feel alive. She feels suffocated in this environment. He wants to help her, but beyond a point, he gets stuck.
Okay.
So she takes an independent decision to do something, and he realizes, boss, this doesn't work like this. I need to at least give my marriage one last shot. I need to try and sort this out. I can't just accept. So he chases her. And it's not about bringing her back. It's about understanding what, which is what he says. एक औरत का किसी मर्द के साथ अफेयर देखा है पहली बार किसी औरत का एक शहर के साथ अफेयर देखा है एंड ही सेज मैं समझना चाहता हूँ शहर में ऐसा है कि सो दैट इज वेयर अगेन द फिल्म गोज इनटू अ फन ट्रिप वेयर द बॉय डिसाइड्स टू स्टे बैक इन इंग्लैंड एंड ही सेज यू नो व्हाट लेट्स सी शो मी प्रूव टू मी व्हाट दिस प्लेस इज ऑल अबाउट
अगेन ही ट्रीट्स इट लाइक ही अंडरस्टैंड्स हर दैट ओके दिस इज द वे टू हैंडल हर
ही सेज ओके देयर इज अ सर्टेन मैडनेस यू हैव अबाउट दिस नो लेट यू प्रूव टू मी चल Yeah. Even I want to see what is so great about
The typical thing would be he would come and hold my hand and say, come on, let's go back. But his character actually is really beautifully mature and very sensible.
He does the exact opposite. He says, you know what, now well, I've come here, let me also take a look.
That's what makes this movie interesting.
I mean, I guess in a certain way, you will get more than you've imagined when you see the film. Because the trailer plays on the simplicity and the charm of what Namaste's world is. But the film will give you far more of it.
So Vipul Shah, I was chatting with him and he said that he's prepared for the comparisons with Namaste London and he's like, because whatever comes second, people tend to look down upon that thing. So what are your...
more than look down, they tend to compare because that's the only way to talk. Hamari bhasha hi aisi ho gayi hai. Arre yaar, wo dekha tune, wo uske tarah dikhta hai na. It's a very common way of communicating. So I don't think that comparison is a real comparison. It's just a way of communicating. It's like saying if I meet you, hey, yeah, I've seen you, sir, you look like that guy. And then we move on into a conversation. It's just a very normal way we talk. It's good only to be compared to London. Namaste London. There's nothing wrong with it. It's a good film.
Yeah.
I'll take the comparison any day.
He was also talking about the music because Namaste London music was phenomenal. And what from all the songs what I have heard so far, they're amazing. I love Tere Liye especially. And then he said that there's another song coming of Rahat Fateh Ali Khan, which will be coming in a few days.
Amazing, yeah.
So, something about that song you want to talk about?
That is the tribal song. So
he said it's on similar.
Remember Main Jahan Rahun. So, we have a song that is reminiscent of that situation.
Okay.
In the sense, when there is a man arriving in another world, so a man from our country arriving into another universe altogether. And the lyrics this time are far more romantic.
Okay.
I guess Main Ja Raha Hoon also had a slight tinge of patriotism in it.
Yeah.
It was a subtext of patriotism. Main Ja Raha Hoon, Teri Yaad Saath Hai was more about even the country that you're thinking about. That was that layer that Javed Saab had brought in. Oh, here it is. I will go through anything because you are mine and I'm yours. Because through the journey, he's smiling through all the madness and all the sadness because he's only reminding himself that you are mine and I am yours and I will go to any extent for you, which is what makes him reach.
So finally, because you have been working it's been 6 years, you guys know each other and you have worked together. So what we'll do is just a quick
quiz.
So if you can say three statements about yourself, one will be lie and she has to guess which one is lie.
Oh
and
God.
same she'll say about herself.
Okay, so three statements that I have to say, one is a lie. So I have to say all the three and then she has to choose.
Yeah, so you can say two correct statements about yourself and one lie.
Truths and a lie.
Yeah.
Oh God, you sochna padega. I also have to do it after this.
Yeah.
I'm very grumpy and irritable every morning when I wake up.
Mm-hmm.
That's one statement. The first time you meet me, you'll not see me smiling or talking and after that you'll not see me shut up.
Mm-hmm.
I never use abusive language in regular conversation.
So I have to choose a lie?
Yeah.
The third one is a lie. He's very grumpy in the morning. It takes 45 minutes for a very important man called Feroz to wake him up. The first time you meet him, he'll appear to be a very quiet, reserved guy. But then you spend 7 years and you realize we don't know how we made it. He never uses abusive. That is true.
That's a lie.
I
mean, I use abusive. Nah, so it is true that he never uses abusive language.
No.
He said he never uses.
I use.
So that's the lie, no?
No. I said I never use abusive language in regular conversation.
Yeah. So the truth is that
He
I
usually
realize subconsciously
yeah.
I always
end okay. Sorry. The truth is that he does. That's what I'm trying to say.
Subconsciously,
sorry,
I end up using explicit
okay.
words that we can't say here.
Okay. Yeah.
Push pe ghar se case na lag jaye.
Okay, so I have to say two truths and a lie. Okay. The first statement is my biggest passion in my life is to travel and see the world. Second statement is I'm a morning person. I love mornings and I'm very chirpy in the morning. And third one is I love tomato ketchup.
Third one must be false.
That came out of nowhere.
But tum aur Shraddha, same problem with tumko.
Yeah.
Shraddha also hates tomato.
Yeah, yeah, she hates. She
detests tomato.
I can't stand it. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like I remember on set, she used to run away from it.
No, itna main pagal nahi hu. I love the hot and sweet. I like chili basically. I like spicy food. So tomato ketchup is like a.
But I wouldn't have known this. I just knew the other two are true.
Exactly that.
Abhi tumhe sab kuch pata hai mere baare
mein.
Yeah.
We have to listen to the fans.
Kya hum sach mein dost hai? Oh God.
Well, that's not what fans are saying. But their chemistry here is amazing. And if you want to see more of it, you're going to watch Namaste England. Thank you so much. That's one of my side. Thank you.
Thank you.